Hello, and welcome to this video demo. I'd like to introduce a new capability in ADS 2011 that allows you to quickly change which models are used in a simulation. This low-pass filter isn't just a single design. It has many different representations. A benefit of this approach is that it is a more convenient way of organizing and sharing your work. It has a schematic ideal view. It has a more realistic schematic PDK view. It has a layout view in which the filter is implemented using microstrip elements. It has an EM model view, which contains results from an EM simulation. These filters all have different frequency responses. These are the responses of the ideal filter. Here I have added the responses of the microstrip implementation. And here I've added the frequency responses of the EM model. These three markers are set to the same frequency, and you can see that as we move them, the impedance of the different filters is not the same. This will lead to slightly different performance of the amplifier depending upon the filter we connect to it. Dynamic model selection allows you to quickly change which model for a component is simulated without having to edit the schematic. Here I am showing how the text under the component name changes as I select which model to simulate. Now you can answer quickly what happens to your design's performance when you switch from an ideal design to a much more accurate and realistic EM model, for example. If the change is large, it might indicate a part of your design to focus on. This is a powerful capability because it can be applied in both simple and large hierarchical designs. In earlier releases, changing models required extensive schematic modification. For example, you'd have to activate the model you wanted to simulate and deactivate the model you didn't want to simulate. Of course, this use model is still available in ADS 2011. Up to now, I've just shown a very simple example. What happens if you have a design with many components or with many levels of hierarchy? Hierarchy policies that you define allow you to quickly change throughout the hierarchy which views will be simulated. The view that is simulated depends on the order of the views in the hierarchy policy list. In this case, the EM model view will be simulated for each component, provided it exists. If not, the schematic or the layout view will be simulated. This policy could be considered a highly accurate one, whereas this policy could be considered a fast but less accurate one with schematic ideal ahead of schematic and EM model. Of course, you may also override the hierarchy policy and manually specify which view is used for specific instances. Simulate Hierarchy Explorer is another method of specifying which view will be simulated. This could be particularly useful for setting the view to be simulated in a large hierarchical design. We simulated the gain and gain compression of this amplifier driving this filter. We changed the models of the filter and compared the responses. We wrote the responses into different data sets, making it easier to compare the results for the gain and gain compression shown here. Thank you for watching this video demo. For a free trial of the advanced design system, please visit our website.